Very good evening. Today we are going to discuss about the topic called basic input and output operations. So this is under module number one, that is a basic structure of computers and machine instructions and programming. So basic input and output operations. So the main concept what we have to understood over here is by using a single bus. Okay, by using a single bus, we are all the by using a single bus and processor, all the operations is going to be happen. So how it is happening? For example, if I am going to press A in the keyboard, so we need two things: one is keyboard and another one is monitor. So if I am going to press A, so the afterwards what will happen? So A is displayed in the monitor. So how it is going to happen? So we are in a blind mode. We don't know what is happening internally, background scenes, what and all happening inside the computer. We really don't know. So this concept is really helpful. And in this basic input and output operations, what and all we are using over here is by using the status flags and the thing is data in buffer and then data out buffer. So all the operations once the user is pressing any kind of letters, okay, any kind of things, how it is transmitted to the data out buffer and how it is happening, everything we are going to see now. So this is a basic input and output operations. So data are transferred between the memory of a computer and the outside world. So here these operations are very important, and the way they are performed have a most significant effect on the performance of the computer. And the performance of the computer is totally depend upon the design of the hardware and compiler, we can say, and the machine instructions and everything and coming under. And consider a task that read in a character input from a keyboard and produces a character output on a display screen. So we already discussed this. When I am going to press A in the keyboard, and automatically in monitor it is displaying as A. How I entered, the same thing it will be displayed on the monitor. So internally what is happening? So everything is done by the processor. So what is the main function of the processor? So within a tremendous speed of operations, how many letters we are entering, everything will be displayed on the monitor, that we'll see now. So these input and output tasks can be performed by using the two methods. One is program controlled input output and memory mapped input output. So program controlled input output, in the simple method, this is a very simple method and it is used to perform this input output task. So the rate of data transfer from the keyboard to the computer and from the computer to the display is still much slower than the speed of the processor. So all the operations, all the input and output operations is take care of by the a single bus and by the processor. So all not all the buses is having a same kind of speed, and the same kind of speed we can say we are using the electronic buffer, or we can say it is a buffer register, so the, or catch register. So these, by using this we can see internal operations and all. How it is going to take it off? So how it is going to process inside the computer? We don't know anything. So that we'll see how it is. The mechanism used to synchronize the transfer of data between them is an output, input, and moving a character code from the keyboard to the processor. So here, this is the main important diagram of this basic input and output operation. So we are having a single bus. By default processor is connected to the bus, and we have two things. One is data in register and data output register. So by default these things will be connected to the bus in all the computers, we can say. Whenever a user is pressing any letter in the keyboard, so what is happening? For example, I am entering A in the keyboard. So the first thing is for keyboard, and second thing is for the display, or we can say it is a monitor. So here what is happening? If I am going to press A or anything, if I am entering in the keyboard, immediately what is happening? Data in register it is going to store, and then afterwards what is by default, you know, SIN and SOUT. So these two things is by default. This is a flags, we can say it is a flags. So SIN is nothing but a status input flag, and sout is nothing but a status output flag. So by default, it will take 0. You see, by default it will take 0, and it's the same thing, status output flag, it will take 0. So whenever the user pressing A in the keyboard, it is stored in the data in register, and then now status input flag becomes 1. So already it is 0, now it is 1. Why? Because I entered A in the keyboard. So now afterwards, what is happening? The processor. So all these things, all the functions which is done by the processor. So now afterwards, what will happen? The processor, whatever the value, whatever the information we stored in the data in register, so everything will be transferred, that particular information or instruction, and the processor take that particular instructions and it move to the data out register. So in the data register, A is there. So in the data out register, be clear, in data out register, A is there. Now in data in register, nothing is there. Okay, so in data in register, A is erased. So A is erased by the processor. So and then status input flag becomes 0. By default it is 0. Once it is the processor takes these instructions to the data out register, though, so data in register information will get erased, and the status input flag will become 0. Now when coming to this monitor, so now data out having the value called A, so whatever we entered in that keyboard, now it is stored in data out register, and now yes, status output flag value become 1. The status output flag value become 1. So this processor has done all these things, and now when we are seeing, once we are seeing in seeing the monitor, it will become whatever we have pressed in the keyboard A will be shown in the monitor. Now what is happening in data out register, it seems, so that value will become erased by the processor. That value will become erased by the processor, and yes out, that is status output flag, so this will become 0. So this will become 0. So not only one letter, so millions and millions of instructions, whatever the user has typed, so yeah, all the steps and operations, the same kind of operations which is done by the processor. So it's a tremendous speed, like done by this buffer register, we can say. So this is how happening in the basic input and output operations. Whenever if you are going for the competitive exams and all, so they will be asking what is data in and what is data out, and what is SIN, what is S out. So this is a flag, okay, status input flag and status output flag. So this is very important concept in this basic input and output operations. Now it is striking a key stores the corresponding code in 8-bit. And then one more thing we need to understand, what is the size of data in and what is the size of data out, in the sense that is 8, okay, and then here data out is also 8. So this is the size we need to know. And striking a key stores the corresponding code in 8-bit buffer register, that is data in. Data in, it's a 8-bit buffer register, so associated with the keyboard, to inform the processor that a valid character is in data in, a status control flag is set to 1. We already discussed in this diagram. So whenever a user is pressing A in the data in, now what is happening? The SIN, that is status input flag, will become 1. By default it is 0. So to inform the processor that a valid character is in data in, a status control flag is set to 1. A program monitors SIN, and when SIN is set to 1, processor reads the content of data in. When the character is transferred to the processor, SIN is automatically cleared to 0. So once it is transferred to data out, so automatically SIN will become 0. So second character is entered, SIN is again set to 1, and the process repeats as accordingly. When the character are transferred from the processor to display, a buffer register, data out, and the status control flag S out are used. So when S out is equals to 1, the display is ready to receive a character. So we already discussed this. When, see, again and again, how many letters if you are entering in the keyboard, the same process which is happening in the data in buffer register. So that is also, the size is 8-bit. So here also the same process will be happening. Once it is transferred to data out, automatically what is happening in data in, the value will be erased, SIN value become 0. If you are entering, again the value will become set to 1, and then data in value, whatever you are entering, it will be stored. If it is transferred by the processor to the data out, so again what is happening, this will become 0, this will become 1. So this is the main motto, and the processor monitors S out, and when S out is set to 1, the processor transfers a character code to data out. The transfer of a character to data out clears S out to 0. When the display device is ready to receive a second character, S out is again set to 1. So these things will be happening for all the millions of instructions with a tremendous speed of operation. So the buffer registers and status flags are part of device interfaces, and to perform the input and output operation, machine instructions are needed, and that to check the status of status flags and transfer data between the processor and input output devices, we can see input to processor and output to displays. While input to processor, we need a keyboard, and when output to the display, we need a monitor, and then transferring process, we need a data out buffer register. So all these things, what we need is buffer register. So example, they have given read wait branch to read wait if SIN equals to 0, input from data into R1, and for output to display, write wait branch to write wait if S out is 0, output from R1 to data out. It's nothing but, so whenever a user pressed in the keyboard, the buffer register data in data input buffer register will become the value whatever you have pressed, and the status flag will become one. So when it is transferred to the data out buffer register, that is the how it is transferring, by using the processor. So S out buffer register will become the value whatever you have pressed, and in status output flag will become again 1. Okay, so these things every time, it's see how it is a wonder. Okay, whenever a user pressed a letter in the keyboard, immediately we can see the value in the monitor. So this is the main internal functions which is happening inside the computer. So when input and output device and memory share the same address space, the arrangement is called memory mapped input output. Some memory address values are used for refer to peripheral device buffer registers like data in and data out. There is no any special instructions are needed to access the content of these registers, like example move byte data in, R1. Thank you.